Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for joining us today. My name is Matt with 1836 Property Management. Today we want to answer a little bit about maintenance. How much will maintenance cost you? One of the biggest fears that owners have when they're first-time landlords is, how much am I going to spend on maintenance? Well, I've got news for you. We don't know. It's not a crystal ball. I can tell you that if you have a brand new home, just built, you're probably gonna have little to none, and during the first year just about everything will be covered under the builder's warranty. If you've got a home that's a 1920, get ready, because we're gonna have to rebuild almost everything in that home as it goes out, from the clay pipes to the old wiring to the plumbing. The whole thing is gonna be a mess. So where's the happy middle? I would say somewhere between 0 and 10 years old, no more than 20, is an excellent place to start. You know that HVACs are going to last about 10 years on average. Your hot water heater is going to last about 10 years. Your roof's going to last 20 or 30 years, maybe a little bit less given the Texas sun and heat. But those items are your major structural items. So everything else is going to be a little miscellaneous here or there. Now, I will give you fair warning that some tenants don't report things one at a time because they're busy and they don't want to. And so they'll just do with what they have. And then they'll report three items all at one time. Oh, by the way, the sink's not working, the plumbing's not draining properly, and the garbage disposal stopped working 4 months ago. Can you come fix all three? So as an owner, you may get popped with all of those at one time. Best rule of thumb is if you have a newer house, whatever money that we disperse to you, take about 10% of that and put it away in your own savings account. Just create a separate account if you'd like, but save that money. If you have a 10 to 20 year old house, maybe take 15%. If you have an older home, you may want to take 20%. I think those are pretty conservative numbers and should even help you for the tenant turnover. Now, a lot of you guys are going to say, wow, that's a lot of money to put away. But the good news is it's in your savings account. So if it's a rainy day and you need it for something else, you would have it available. We certainly do not need to hold that money for you, but it's going to help average things out for you. Keep in mind, this is an investment. Things are going to break. It's not the tenant's fault that they break. It's not God's fault that they break. It is just part of life. And so if you plan for that, you're going to be pleased with it, but you can't have an investment without investing. So you're going to have to maintain this property. The result is of failing to maintain it is that you're going to have a property that's probably worth less 10 years down the road because it's going to be in horrible condition. We get a number of customers that come from other property management companies because those companies are simply scared to tell them that they need to make repairs consistently. It's one of the hardest things we do is reach out to owners and say, hey, we need you to give us some more money and more money and more money. But the difference is when it's time to sell that property, you've got something that's already made ready. It's in pristine condition, it's maintained properly, and you're not having to fix $10,000 or $20,000 of items that have turned into $20,000 and $40,000 of items because you just avoided it. So we're here to really tell you the truth and let you know what's going on. We want to work with you as an honest partner, and sometimes that means sharing bad news. Hopefully no news is good news when it comes to maintenance. But as a rule of thumb, if you take 10 to 20%, depending on the age of the house, and put it away in your own savings, that should help you even with the tenant turnover, which may require repainting, reflooring, things of that nature on an annual basis, and you'll have that money in your pocket for a rainy day when it comes. If we can help you with any of your investment properties here in Austin, Texas, please reach out to us. We're 1836 Property Management.